So we have seen in last video that write a C program to return address of a last node of the linked list. This is last second node from last second node address we need to return, right? So think carefully that we have written last node of the linked list. This one we have written in previous video, right? That means previous problem. So now we need to return this last node, this address we have to return. So how can we do that? What we have done is we have started here. So we have started here. If it is empty, we'll directly return that empty node only. So because we don't have anything, so if we have two, then we need to return this particular one, okay? So if we don't have if it is next value is not equal to null, then we are moving forward. So what I do now, my s is here, I'm checking that s dot next not equal to null, true. So what I'm doing from here, I'm moving here, that is s is equal to s came here. So again I checked here that s is equal s dot next not equal to null, then I'm moving here, so s is here, okay? Now I'm checking again, I'm coming here, s dot next, s is equal to s dot next, so my s is here. Now I came here, s is equal to s dot next, so my s is here. Now I am checking, s is equal to s dot next, right? So we found out that this is the null value. So we don't have any nodes. We came to last node, right? We came last node. But see, every time we changed s, we moved s here, okay, here s, but we need this address we need. So how can we come back? Already we have moved further, so how can we come back? That is, can we do one thing? Every iteration, can we assign s to some new variable? Yeah, we'll try that. We assign some value to the new variable, that is called some kind of, you can take it before you are moving to s equal to s next. Can I do some p equal to s? Yeah, p will be there. Again, I will do p equal to s. Yeah, I will do p equal to s. There is a pointer I am moving. Will I do p equal to s? Yeah, true. Shall I do p equal to s? See, whenever I get to enter this, I could not able to write this one. You are able to get it right. I don't write this because when I get s equal to s next equal to not equal to null, then only I am entering, right? So here you can wait that. So now I have the address. I know that I reach last node, s is last node. So I believe that p is last second node. P is last second node, right? I believe that p is the last second node. You can see this is the last node and this is the last second node. So what you need to return? Return p. That's it, right? Very simple. So if you understand the last video, this is very simple. I am writing the program for that. For suppose you can take a function, function having struct node starting as given as. So you can define struct node star p. Okay, what I am doing, if s equal to null, return I am returning null. Okay, if I have only one node, what I need to do, I have only one node, that is you can consider I have only one node in the linked list, for suppose, and this is null, there is no second right. So you do one thing, that s dot next not equal to null, then only you will enter into loop, right? So here if it is having only one node, I am assigning p equal to null, right? P equal to null, because it won't enter into null, because it is null, so I am returning p, that means null, because it's a only one node. In one node we don't say that we exist some node. If we say that some node is existing, that means that is the null only, right? So while s next not equal to null, s next not equal to null, then what I do, p equal to s is equal to s dot next, right? I will return p. Okay, see, if you have doubts I will explain very clearly again now. So first my s is at, I am getting 1000 here first. Okay, my p is null, so I have pointers, I have memory location, that is for p and for s. So address is 1000 and p is assigned to null. It is having 1000 and it is assigned to null. So s not equal to null, s is not equal to null, so I move to here, s next, 1000 next, 1000 dot next, 1000 dot next, not equal to null, because it is having address of 2000, so not equal to null. What I am doing, I am assigning this s address to s value to p, that is I am assigning 1000 here in this, and I am moving s equal to s dot net. What is s dot next? S is at 1000 dot next. What is 1000 next? That is I am moving to whatever 2000 I am moving there, so it is now 2000. Okay, next. So s dot next, what is s now? 2000 dot next, not equal to null, true, because 2000 dot next, that is 3000, not equal to null, true, it came inside. What is s now? S is now 2000, so I assign to 2000 to p. Now what I am doing, s equal to s next, so what is my s now? 2000. What is my s next? 2000 next is 3000, I am moving 3000 here, so again I came here, s next. What is s? S is 3000. What is 3000 next? 4000, not equal to null, true. What is p? P is 2000, I am assigning s value to p. What is s? S is 3000, I am assigning 3000 here. Now s equal to s next, s is 3000, s next is 4000, So I am assigning 4000 here. Okay. So again, I move to here. While S next, what is S? S is 4000. S next, 4000 next is 5000. So not equal to null, true. P equal to S. I am making S value to P. What is S value now? 4000. I am making it to 4000. Okay. I am moving S equal to S next. S next is 5000. S is 4000 and S 4000 next is 4000 next is 5000. I am moving S value to 5000. So I came here. S is 5000. What is 5000 next? 5000 next is null. So what is S next not equal to null? The statement is false, fail, because the S is 5000 next. What is 5000 next? Equal to null. So true, this is true and this is false. So when once this is false, we directly come here. We return P. What is the P? 4000. We are returning 4000. What we need to decide in written in this note, in this problem, we have to return address of 4000, right? Second, this is the first node and this is the second node from the last, from the end. 4000 we need to return. What we have written? 4000. Yeah, we'll discuss remaining things in other video.